It's working!
It's working! It's working!
Today we'll show you how to go from this to this. Okay, not really. But we do have 4 steps on how to fix your doorbell. Let's get started. I've been using the Eufy security doorbell camera for 3 years, and it's been amazing. It has a very clear picture, connects to Alexa, and the best part, it does not require a monthly subscription. Unfortunately, 6 months ago, it stopped working. I assumed it followed the path of Fix-It Felix Jr. and needed to be put out to pasture, like Mr. Litwack's Nana. So then I purchased this, a battery-powered doorbell camera. After I installed the camera, I pushed the button, and although it sent an alert to Alexa, the actual doorbell chime did not ring. So then I had the thought, maybe my favorite doorbell camera should not be put out to pasture. Something else could be wrong. I followed a series of troubleshooting steps and was able to fix the issue. These 4 steps can be used for both a smart doorbell camera and a regular doorbell. We'll start with step 1, which is the doorbell button. It could be a simple doorbell button, like this one, or it can be more complex, like a Ring or Nest doorbell camera. The main tool you need for this step is a screwdriver. Before you get started, locate the breaker box and turn off the breaker to the doorbell. Once the power is off, remove your doorbell. If you have a smart doorbell, you might have a special tool to remove the doorbell. If it's a simple doorbell like this, you just need that screwdriver. Once the doorbell's removed, inspect the doorbell button. Look at the back of the doorbell. Make sure the wires connected to the doorbell are tight. Make sure the button works and it isn't falling apart. Check to see if the wires have dust or paint on them. That could be blocking the connection. If you have a Ring doorbell that's battery powered, make sure the screws on the doorbell mount are screwed all the way in. Many people find this fixes their issue because the battery is not connecting to those terminals tight enough to give it that actual charge. If the doorbell button looks good, that might not be the issue. Let's move on to step 2, the doorbell chime. There are 2 types of chimes. One is a mechanical chime, and the other is an electric chime. If your doorbell looks like this one, then you have a mechanical chime. If it's square and has more musical tune, it's probably an electronic doorbell like this. For this step, you'll just need that screwdriver again. For mechanical doorbells, make sure your chime is positioned horizontally, not vertically. To check to see if it's working properly, pull off the cover and flick the 2 pistons. They should move freely like this. Just check and make sure they're clean. While you're at it, check the wire connections. If you have an electronic doorbell, the cover is a little more tricky to pull off, but with enough force, it should just pop off. Hopefully. Once the cover is off, unscrew the 4 screws and carefully pull it out. Don't pull too hard or the wires might disconnect. Oh, and by the way, your power should still be turned off, especially because when the power is on, that black wire will have a high voltage flowing through it and you could get shocked. Once you've pulled out the electronic doorbell, take a look at the wires on the back. You will most likely have 4 wires and possibly 6 if you have 2 doorbell buttons. The black and white wires on the one side are what take power from your house to what's called the transformer. We'll talk more about the transformer in the next step. The 2 wires on the other side, which are typically red, white, green, those take the signal from the doorbell button to the chime. Make sure the black and white wires are connected to the wires coming from your house. Also, make sure the other 2 wires are inserted into the slots on the back. If you look closely, you'll notice a plus and minus symbol next to each of those slots. Make sure the wires go into a plus and a minus, not 2 pluses and not 2 minuses. It won't work that way. If all the wires are tight and wired correctly, you're ready to move on to the next step, the transformer. No, unfortunately, not that kind of transformer. This transformer takes the high voltage from your house and converts it down to a lower voltage between 16 and 24 volts. Transformers are usually located behind the doorbell chime, inside of the doorbell chime, or you might find it in your garage, utility closet, attic, or next to the breaker. Now for this step, you'll need a screwdriver and a multimeter. Some of you might not know what a multimeter is. Don't worry, we'll explain what you need to do. If you don't have a multimeter, you could pick up a cheap one from Amazon or at your local hardware store. They may seem intimidating, but we're gonna show you what to do. Now hold up. If at any point you don't feel comfortable with doing this, please stop what you're doing and go find a mechanic. An electrician. Before you begin this step, make sure you get to the end of the video because you may or may not need to buy a new transformer depending on the doorbell that you have. The first thing you need to do is find where your transformer is located. Once you've located your transformer, make sure the 2 screws on the front are holding those wires tight. Sometimes these transformers get covered with paint and that might block the connection between the wires and the transformer. If it looks clean and the wires are snug, it's time to turn your power back on. Grab your multimeter and turn the dial to either 200 or 500. 500. Putting your dial to 200 or 500 basically means the voltage you're testing will not go above that amount. There's a possibility it could go above 200. If that's the case, it's safe just to put it to 500. Take the black pin and touch it to one of the screws while also taking the red pin and touching it to the other screw. If your multimeter shows anything between 16 volts and 24 volts, that means your transformer is working properly. If it isn't showing anything, then either your transformer is bad or the wires behind your transformer are not properly connected. You've already checked that, so it could be you just have a bad transformer. The last thing you check on the transformer are the little numbers on the front. If the transformer showed 16 volts on your multimeter and it has 10 VA, that means you might need to upgrade to a 30 VA transformer. What that means is it's going to feed more power to your doorbell. And if you have a smart doorbell, the majority of them require 30 VA. That was my issue. My transformer was reading 19 volts, but it wasn't pushing enough power to my doorbell. So my solution was I purchased a new transformer, installed it correctly, and it was good as new. I had no idea where to look for a transformer. Luckily, I found a pretty cheap one on Amazon. In fact, I'll leave a link in the comments or in the description in case you're looking for one. Remember I said don't get started until you finish this video? Well, if you have an electronic doorbell, it has a transformer inside.
My name is Optimus Prime.
If you find that your transformer is not powerful enough, you might want to just purchase a new doorbell chime. I found this one on Amazon for a pretty decent price. It says it works with smart doorbell cameras, and it seems to work pretty well. I'll leave a link in the description or the comments for this product as well. Two of my brothers have issues with their doorbells. One has a smart doorbell, one has a regular doorbell. I challenge them to see if these steps in this video will help them fix their issues. If you've tried all these steps and you still can't get your doorbell to work, please let us know. Leave us a comment. We will respond and see if we can find a solution together. Now, if you know someone who has a doorbell issue, take this knowledge to them. Show them you can fix their doorbell, or if it's easier or they're too far away, just send them a link to this video. Now that you have a fixed doorbell, look inside your cabinet vents. You might be surprised what you find, and this video will tell you what to look for. Or you can just take a look at this video right here. Thank you for watching. I hope this helped you out.
All right. Shoot. That's the second time I've dropped my phone.
That is definitely where my phone hit the wall twice as it was falling down. Twice.